Thanks very much. Thank you. Excellent. It's good to be here, actually. Good to be... I love Montreal, because here's the one reason. You don't need a lot of money to have a good time in Montreal, and I'm broke, so it's perfect. This is what I like to do for fun. It's cheap, and it's fun. I like to go into government buildings where they have those signs up that say, we would be happy to serve you in either English or French. And I always ask to be served in French, and then I stand there going, what? What the hell are you saying to me? Then they start up in English. No, French, please. Oh, God, that's a pretty language. And it's my right to do that, too. That's the beauty of it. You know? Stand there for hours. Excellent. I grew up in a very small farming town out west in Saskatchewan. That's probably why I don't speak French. I got to go back there recently, actually. I got to see my mother again. That was the big treat for me. Hadn't saw my mom in like a year and a half, I think, which is too long for me. I'm a big mama's boy, you know, big suck tit baby mama's boy. That's what I am. I am. I miss my mother. Because I grew up very close to my mom. My friends think this is strange because they say they never did this with their mother. My mom and I used to box. Is that odd? You ever do that with your mom? Just strap them up and go with the old gal? You ever do that? They're tougher than you think, you know. You'd be surprised, because you don't think she's going to be tough, you know. It's your mom. You always see her in the kitchen. She's got like a frilly apron on and fuzzy slippers. You think I could hang a holy beating on her if I had to? I'm sure of it. Why the hell was I ever scared of her, come to think of it? Ooh, big tray of muffins. Very scary, mom. Ooh. You're a killer. No, but don't sell them short. They're very tough. See, they've been kicking your ass since day one. That's the thing, you know. They know all your moves. They can fake you out. Mm-hmm. You tried that in grade 7, remember? Yeah. She's tough. But just for fun, my mom and I, we box, and we never hit each other. We're never supposed to. But this last time I was at home, I guess I got better than I was before, because I popped her one. I didn't mean to. She had her little dukes up there. She was prepared. But it snuck right in between. We're goofing around. Okay, look out, mommy. Okay. Ooh, woo. I punched my mom in the mouth. And it's pretty hard to feel proud of that. You know, it's pretty hard to punch your mom in the mouth and then gloat afterwards. You can't just like, yeah. Yeah, you all see that? Who's making the rules now, Ma, huh? No, you clean your room. How about that? Felt like a knob. I punched my mom in the mouth. And the thing that worried me, too, was she didn't really look hurt. You know, she just kind of looked at me. She went, ah. Apron comes off. Okay. Let's go, then. That scares me. Yeah, my mom gets that mad. Her fists just turn into claws, you know. There's no more boxing now. She's a badger coming at my head. Get her off me. Tears my whole face off. She did, actually. This is all plastic surgery here. That's right, I chose this face. That's the one I picked out of the face catalog there. Page 97, if you're wondering. Yeah, it scared me, though. My mom, she's mad now. She's chasing me around the house. Thank God she has a bad hip. I just run upstairs. Safe upstairs. I sit on the 8th stair. She can't quite reach, you know? She's just clawing at my socks. Come on! Come on down! Round 2, let's go. What? I'm not mad. Yeah, she's got a frying pan behind her back. Come on, it's all forgotten. Come on, don't make a big deal. Clang! Wrap a frying pan around my head.